Hello, Voxelnauts. Let's take a look at the basics of VoxEdit's modeler. If you're not already familiar with VoxEdit, check out my introduction to the beta version here. After creating a new file, we are greeted with an empty object volume. This is 1 cubic meter in the sandbox game maker scale, or 32 by 32 by 32. From the menu at the top, we can change the size of each dimension between 1 and 256. For anything designed for the game maker, we only go up to 128 cubed. The game maker uses these volumes as bounding boxes, so it's important to fit them tightly to your finished object using the trim button. By default, the first tool selected is the pen with create mode active. Left-clicking or dragging anywhere in the object volume will place voxels with the selected palette swatch. Voxels are linked to their swatch, so modifying the color in the material panel will automatically update the voxels using it. The other three modes are select, paint, and erase. Select will highlight the voxels you choose so you can move, copy, or delete them. Paint will recolor voxels that have already been placed with a different swatch, and erase will remove voxels from the object. The other tools change the shape of how you modify voxels, and they work with every mode. The line tool stretches voxels from where you click to where you release. Box forms a rectangular prism from click to release. Face modifies a contiguous plane, and flood a contiguous volume with the same swatch. The picker tool will select the swatch of any voxel you click, and return you to the tool you were using before. You can use the Alt key or Option on Macs as a shortcut. The Pivot tool sets the center of rotation for an object in the animator. If this object is used in the game maker without a rig, this will act as the object's origin. The File menu has a shortcut for opening the folder containing the current file, Save and Save As, and an export menu for several formats and uploading to the marketplace. The Edit menu has buttons for undo, redo, clipboard operations, and selection functions. Increase and reduce resolution will double or halve the current size of an object. Voxels always maintain the same 32 to 1 meter scale in the game maker, so doubling the detail will also double the size. Reduce is a destructive operation, meaning that any detail that is too small will be erased and can only be recovered by undoing the operation. The next set of buttons rotate and flip the object. And these turn on the mirror feature for symmetrical sculpting. Each axis is color-coded. Red is X, green is Y, and blue is Z. Every button related to the axis match this scheme, and the lines are drawn in color on the volume itself as a reminder. The colored arrows are scroll buttons, which will shift your whole model in the selected direction. Any voxels that reach the end loop back to the other side. The last five buttons at the top control how you see your model, with buttons to view the edges of your object and voxel grid, and the target button will reset the camera view to the default position. There are several more options for controlling your view. The top corner can switch to 2 and 4 view panes, with one in 3D and the rest as 2D views. You can also toggle the 3D view between perspective and orthographic modes. In the bottom corner are options to toggle the axis and object front indicators, the floor and wall grids, and ghost image for other objects on a rig if you're editing an attached object. The screenshot button will save a PNG image of your 3D view pane with a transparent background to users/your username/voxedit. This folder also holds some example models and stores error logs if you need to visit our Discord server for support. Link in the description. There's a lot more to unpack in VoxEdit's modeler, but if you found this video a helpful start, please give it a thumbs up, subscribe, and ring the bell to be notified when more tutorials are available. Thanks for watching.